Securing the accuracy is very important, and therefore the instruments should always be checked in a frequent manner. The procedure is a simple one, and we will be demonstrating it today in this tutorial. We are using glass filters, and they are standardized size 10 × 10 mm, so they are designed to fit into all spectrophotometers. The frame is engraved with a filter type and a serial number for identification purposes. Be sure to clean the filters with a lint-free cloth before inserting them into the instrument. During measurement, you should always keep an eye on the temperature and the humidity because they can impact the results in the end. And the temperature is most optimal between 20 degrees Celsius and 24 degrees Celsius, and the humidity should be between 30% and 65%. And these informations are also stated on the calibration certificate, which comes with each instrument we sell. So there are several steps to take before the calibration. So you first need to switch on the instrument and let it preheat for at least 20 minutes, because during this time the instrument is executing a wavelength reset and dark current by itself. We also recommend connecting the instrument to a tablet or a laptop, so you can carry out all the scans using the PC software. As said before, the filters should be cleaned with a lint-free cloth before inserting them into the instrument. The filters should be placed correctly into the light path, this is very important. And the filters also should always face the same direction, for example with the serial number towards the detector. These neutral density glass filters are made from special selected filter materials, and they come with a certificate. So these filters are called N2, which has the absorbance of 0.25. N3, which has the absorbance of 0.5, and N4, which has the absorbance of 1.0. These filters are an excellent choice when you measure within the visible wavelength range from 405 to 800 nanometers. And in the PC software, you should set the wavelength range to 440 to 635 nanometers. After the preparations we just made, you can now select the mode multi-wavelength analysis on your PC software, and you should set the range of wavelengths as stated on the calibration certificate. Then you should carry out a blank at first, and afterwards you can measure the filters N2 to N4. You can always check which filter is being analyzed by checking the number engraved on the bar. You should always take several measurements to avoid errors and also save the data you just collected with the PC software, for example. After the calibration of the photometric accuracy, we will measure the wavelengths with the holmium oxide filter, which is called H1. Now you can select the mode wavelength scan on your PC software, and be sure to include all the wavelength peaks, which are listed on the calibration certificate, and select a wavelength range between 250 and 650 nanometers. You should always select a slow scanning speed and small intervals, because this will lead to the most precise results. Always carry out the blank at first, and then after the blank is done, you can do a wavelength scan with the H1 filter. Be sure to take several measurements again, as said before, because it will lead to the most accurate results when you take the average amount. In the end, you should compare the results you received through the PC software with the certified values enlisted on the calibration certificate. To be able to calibrate the spectrophotometers, we offer the EMC-SET 100 with all filters necessary, And the filters are certified DAkkS and NIST reference material, so therefore they are of high quality. Finally, we have 5 tips for you. First of all, we recommend calibrating the spectrophotometer according to the quality guidelines in your laboratory. The second tip is to secure the results. You should always use a PC software, for example, to collect all the data. The third tip is to keep the calibration certificate always in a safe place, so you can always check the certified results with the measured results on your instrument. The fourth tip is that you can get a calibration guide on request. And last but not least, we offer a pre-programmed file for the wavelength and photometric accuracy for all our PC softwares on request. So if you have any questions, please do not hesitate to ask in the comments, and if you want to stay updated, you can subscribe our channel.